हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू आर सेफ एट होम. स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल गोइंग टू लर्न जीके यूनिट नंबर 28 एंड आवर टॉपिक इज स्पेस एक्सप्लोरेशन पार्ट 2. सो नाउ लेट्स लर्न अबाउट आवर टॉपिक. So now we continue in second part. So it's a number 5. The astronaut who first went to the first woman to go into space. So it's a Valentina Tereshkova. Valentina Tereshkova. So children, here we can see a photograph of Valentina Tereshkova. So Valentina Valdimirovna Tereshkova is a member of the Russian State Duma, engineer and former cosmonaut, and she is the first and youngest woman to have flown in space with a solo mission on the Vostok 6 on 16 June 1963. So Valentina Tereshkova is a member of the Russian State Duma, engineer and former cosmonaut, and she is the first and youngest woman to have flown in a space with a solo mission on the Vostok 6 on 16 June 1963. So children's, Valentina Tereshkova was born in Bolshoi Maslenikovo on March 6, 1937. And for a woman, were selected to be a trained for a special woman in a space program. Out of the 4 women selected, Valentina Tereshkova was the only one to complete a space mission. So Tereshkova were selected to be trained for a special woman in space program, and out of the 4 women selected, Valentina Tereshkova was the only one to complete a space mission. And Tereshkova was launched on the Vostok 6 on June 16, 1963, and become the first woman to fly in a space. Tereshkova was launched on Vostok 6 on June 16, 1963, and become the first woman to fly in a space. During the 70.8 hour flight, Vostok 6 made a 48 orbit of Earth. So Tereshkova was born in Bolshoi Maslenikovo on March 6, 1937, and for a woman were selected to be a trained for a special woman in space program. Out of the four women selected, Valentina Tereshkova was the only one to complete a space mission. Tereshkova was launched on the Vostok 6 on June 16, 1963 and became the first woman to fly in space. During the 70.8-hour flight, Vostok 6 made a 48 orbits of Earth. So children, Valentina Tereshkova was the first woman to go in a space. So here also we have see a photograph of Vostok 6. So it's a look like this. And here we see a Valentina Tereshkova. So the first woman in a space was Soviet cosmonaut Valentina Tereshkova. Her expertise as a pursuist gave this factory worker a chance to be a cosmonaut, and she orbited the Earth 48 times in 1963. So, aboard Vostok 6, although her flight was considered a novelty and she never took manual control of the spacecraft, she became a national heroine in the USSR. So, she married a fellow cosmonaut, and their daughter Elena became the first child born of parents who had both been in a space. So, spacecraft, and she became a national heroine in USSR. She married a fellow cosmonaut, and their daughter Elena became the first child born of parents who had both been in a space. So the first woman in a space was Soviet cosmonaut Valentina Tereshkova, and her expertise as a pursuitized gave this factory worker a chance to be a cosmonaut, and she orbited the Earth 48 times in 1963 aboard Vostok 6. So children, Valentina Tereshkova cosmonaut career. We see a photograph of Tereshkova. So, female cosmonaut flights considered for a mostly propaganda purpose. Korolev directed female cosmonaut selection, and Khrushchev made final selection for first female flight. So, female cosmonaut flights considered for a mostly propaganda purposes. Korolev directed female cosmonaut selection, and Khrushchev made a final selection for a first female flight. So children, Valentina Tereshkova first flight Vostok 5 had been planned for a record 8 days in a space. Here we see Valentina Tereshkova. So Vostok 5 had been planned for a record 8 days in a space. Mabaikovsky had trouble with his thermal regulation system and landed after only 5 days, just 3 hours after Vostok 6. So, Valentina Tereshkova landed after only 5 days, just 3 hours after Vostok 6. So, children, you all are understand about Valentina Tereshkova. She was the first woman to go into space. Now, next, the astronaut who first went to the moon. Where? So, it's Edwin Aldrin Armstrong and Michael Collins. So, here we see a photograph of three astronauts, and they are went to the moon first, and Apollo 11 launched from Cape Canaveral on July 16, 1969, and carrying a Commander Neil Armstrong, Commander Module Pilot Michael Collins, and Lander Module Pilot Edwin Buzz Aldrin into initial Earth orbit of 114 by 116 miles. So, Neil Armstrong, Edwin Aldrin, and Michael Collins, these three person astronaut went to the moon first. So, here we see on a board where Neil Armstrong, the commander of the mission, Michael Collins, and the commander module pilot, and Edwin Buzz, Aldrin Lander, and module pilot. So, children, astronaut Armstrong emerged from the spacecraft first while descending, he released the modularized equipment storage assembly MESA, on which the surface television camera was stowed, and the camera recorded humankind's first step on the moon. So, astronaut Armstrong emerged from the spacecraft first while descending, he released the modularized equipment storage assembly MESA, on which the surface television camera was stowed, and the camera recorded humankind's first step on the moon. So, children, a sample of lunar surface material was collected and stored to assure that if a contingency required an early end to the planted surface activities, samples of lunar surface material would be returned to Earth. And astronaut Aldrin subsequently descended to the lunar surface. So a sample of lunar surface material was collected and stored to assure that if a contingency required an early end, the planned surface activities, samples of lunar surface material would be returned to Earth. Astronaut Aldrin subsequently descended to the lunar surface. So children, Apollo 11 was the space flight that landed the first human on the moon. And Americans Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin walked on the moon on July 20, 1969. So children, Neil Armstrong and Aldrin Buzz walked on moon on July 20, 1969. So children, here we see a three person that go first in a moon. So children, now what does ISRO stand for? So ISRO, ISRO, here we see Indian Space Research Organization. So the Indian Space Research Organization, or is the National Space Agency of the Republic of India, headquartered in Bengaluru, and it operates under a Department of Space, which is directly overseen by the Prime Minister of India, while Chairman of ISRO acts as an exclusive of DOS as well. So the ISRO means Indian Space Research Organization, or the National Space Agency of the Republic of India, headquartered in Bengaluru, and it operates under a Department of Space, which is directly overseen by the Prime Minister of India, while Chairman of ISRO act as exclusive of DOS as well. So children, what is ISRO or ISRO? The Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, is the space agency of the Government of India. The Indian Space Research Organization is the space agency of the Government of India. Its vision is to harness space technology for a national development. Its vision is to harness technology of a national development while pursuing space science research and planetary exploration. Its vision is to harness space technology for national development while pursuing space science research and planetary exploration. So ISRO launched many space satellites since its formation. ISRO launched many space satellites since its formation. Now ISRO is not only an official representative of Indian space program, it became a leader of global satellite market with much reliability. So now ISRO is not only a official representative of India's space program, but it became a leader of a global satellite market with much reliability. So children, ISRO, objective of ISRO. The objective of ISRO is to develop space technology. The objective of ISRO is to develop space technology and its application to various national tasks. Accordingly, Indian Space Research Organization. Has successfully operationalized two major satellite systems, namely Indian National Satellite (INSAT) for communication service and Indian remote. So accordingly, Indian Space Research Organization has successfully operationalized two major satellite systems, namely Indian National Satellite for a communication service and Indian remote sensing satellite for a management of natural resources. And also Polar Satellite launched a vehicle PSLV for a launching IRS type of satellites and geostationary satellite launch vehicle GSLV for launching. So this is a objective of ISRO. So about ISRO, it established 15th August 1962 as INCOSPER, and founder of ISRO is Vikram Sarabhai. Vikram Sarabhai is a founder of ISRO. Headquarters Bengaluru and Karnataka, and budget increased ₹90.94 billion in 2017-2018. Website isro.gov.in. So it's a website of ISRO. So children, you all understand about ISRO, what is ISRO and what does ISRO stand for. PSLV C-37. ISRO launches 104 satellites at once, and ISRO's PSLV C-37 launched for 15 February at 9 a.m. ISRO successfully launched record 104 satellites on a single rocket from the Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota. So the rocket is carrying the Kato said 103 other satellites, 96 of which are from the US. So ISRO is stand for Indian ISRO is stand for a Indian Space Research Organization. So now what does NASA stand for? So here we can see a National Aeronautics and Space Administration in the independent agency of the US. NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration is an independent agency of the US federal government responsible for the civilian space program as well as aeronautics and space research. NASA was established in 1958. Succeeding the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics. So, NASA, what is NASA? So, NASA stands for a National Aeronautics and Space Administration. NASA stand for the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, and they count their work in a three different organization. First, aeronautics. Second, human exploration and operations. And third, science. So, NASA in their work is three different organization: aeronautics, human exploration and operations, and science. So NASA was the created on October 1st, 1958. The creation, NASA was created on October 1st, 1958. And it was created in response to Russia's launching of the Sputnik and the first satellite to be launched into space by any country. NASA was created on October 1st, 1958. And it was created in response to Russia's launching of the Sputnik and the first satellite to be launched into space by any country. So, NASA founded in 1958. NASA founded in 1958, and first year after the Soviets launched the Sputnik first, and NASA stand for National Aeronautics and Space Administration. NASA stand for National Aeronautics and Space Administration. And since NASA's inception, there have been 7 major manned space program. NASA founded in 1958, and NASA is a stand for a National Aeronautics and Space Administration. So children, you all are understand about NASA. So children's, hope you all learn and enjoy this lecture. So students, I will see you next time and third part of this lesson. And also students, don't forget to wash your hand regularly, eat healthy food, stay home and stay safe. Bye bye students.